For more on how the budget outlined by the White House is punishing success, we turn to our financial experts. Ed Butowski, he is founder of Chapwood Investments, and Dominic Tavella of Diversified Financial Consultants. Ed, first to you. Again, the concept of the American dream, in my eyes, is achieving success. Whatever that happens, it doesn't necessarily mean you make a lot of money, but it can mean that. It can also mean building businesses. Is that model dead in the eyes of this administration?
Well, I don't know what this administration is thinking, because the facts don't support what their policies are. I mean, success really is defined as the realization of a goal. And everyone has different goals. And somebody might have a goal to be a social worker, and they might make a certain amount of money. Somebody else wants to be a corporate executive. And success is truly defined by achieving that. And that's what the American dream is all about, is achieving what your goals are. And this administration is doing everything to squash that.
And Dom, if you have a kid, and if you punish success, if you punish when they're successful, say they get an A, and every time they get an A, you slap them on the hand. You say, bad kid, bad kid. They're going to stop getting A's. It's the same with businesses. When you swat them every time they succeed, every time they make a decent profit, and you knock them down for doing that, they're going to stop making decent profits.
Look, David, you're absolutely correct. If you look at some of the most successful companies in this country, the Apples of the world, the Googles, the Facebooks, they all started in somebody's garage. It took investors to come in, pump money into those companies, grow them. And look at the employment that these companies have today. Look at the jobs they created, and look at the tax revenue that now is coming to the U.S. Treasury because these companies have been hugely successful. If you foster businesses, if you cradle them, if you help them grow, tax revenue increases. It helps all of America.
Ed Butowski, the percent of GDP that companies and individuals are now putting into the government in terms of tax revenue is very small right now, because the economy, the private sector, is just not growing. It's something like 16-17% right now. The historical average is closer to 20%. The administration knows this. They see the numbers. They realize they need more revenue. How do they think they're going to get it? This private sector is already squeezed by the amount of money they're paying in taxes. How does the administration realistically think they can get more revenue?
Well, look, you got to think, is this politics or is this really trying to grow the economy? Dominic and I both manage money for wealthy people. These people are the ones that really could be out there stimulating the economy, growing the economy. And the way it works right, you know, the way it's working right now, nobody wants to do anything. They have inherent inertia. They will not move. They won't make, you know, any kind of risky bets of any nature with their businesses because they're afraid of what's going to come out of Washington tomorrow. So how do we stimulate this economy? We all know. Everyone watching right now knows. You lower taxes, you stimulate the economy, more revenue goes into the government. We all know that, but this government, the politics right now in Washington, right out of this administration, is about getting reelected, not growing the economy.
And
we
Dom, know that, Ed David. Brings up a great investment strategy point. Are rich people right now more interested in hiding their income than investing their income?
I don't know if so much as hiding it, as much as not putting it at risk. So if you make an investment in a company and you're going to get a capital gains rate back, you're going to get preferential tax treatment, you're going to make that investment. But if you're not going to get any preferential treatment and you're putting that money at risk, why? You consider a municipal bond, sit there, take your chances. I don't need to take the risk on. So you have to give people the incentive to put that money at risk.
Do you see any incentives in the president's budget?
None. And worse, in the real world, the world that we live in, investors, these are large business owners, large meaning under 100 employees, not the mega corporations. They're saying, I don't even want to hire anybody at this point in the game. Let's see how the politics play out, and then we'll decide what we do.
Ed, do you see any investment opportunities from the president's budget? Any special deals that your investors could get in on?
Not a chance in the world. In fact, you know what's really happening now? They're just disgusted. They're disgusted with everything that's said. This one line that Obama says all the time is that Warren Buffett's secretary pays a higher rate than Warren Buffett. That's just not true. Everyone has the same tax rate. It's just a matter of if you decide to take advantage of that or not. Warren Buffett doesn't take any income. He has the same tax rate. And this is the kind of rhetoric that all of our investors are hearing. People are hearing it all over the place. And they're saying, you know what? I'm just not going to play the game. I'm just going to sit on the sidelines. And that's
Ed
the problem.
Ed Butowski, Dom Tavella, great to see you, gentlemen. Have a good night. Thank you very much. Coming up next, can a conservative